When are you seeing Sarah, huh?
Hi, Lisa. Nice to meet you.
What we're going to do is, Katie's in doing hair and makeup at the moment.
All right,
and she's doing an ITV1 interview. But she knows you're travelling, she knows you're not far off, and she's desperate to see you.
Yeah.
We've just got to buy a little bit of time.
Okay, cool.
Come on in.
Yeah, I'm just really anxious to see Katie at the moment. I was expecting to see her as soon as I got to the hotel, and she wasn't here, and we just love each other so much, it's really difficult being apart.
We're done, thank
you very much.
Thank you, sweetie. It's
nice to meet you.
And you too.
It's just been really tough without Katie at home. I've been looking after the kids sort of like on my own sort of a lot of the time. I've had some help from the grandparents and the nanny, which has been great. But without your other half to sort of bolster you along, it's quite tough and quite a new experience for me.
My Mark. My Mark. Where do I live? Back.
My love has come along. My lonely days are over. And life is like a song.
Okay, let's go.
Cheers. Bye.
So Katie and her man had been reconciled.
I'd never heard her call that before.
And before long, it was time for just one last dance of the five senses before the next departure. Lynn Franks. Lynn.
I knew it!
Oh, dear. Poor Lynn. Yeah, I don't know where the strong women thing comes from with Lynn, though. I don't see what the strong woman there is. She's
not necessarily a strong woman, but she's creating a lot of the atmosphere and
creating a lot of tension. Yeah, but that doesn't make her a strong woman. That makes her an irritant.
Shall we invite Lynn round for a beer later?
No.
Huh?
No.
Unfortunately, Lynn was the third celebrity in a row whose partner failed to turn up at the end of the bridge. He had a bit of tummy trouble.
I was in bed by 11 and I just woke up in the early hours of the morning with a really sore stomach. And by the time I got to sleep, I'd slept through it all. For the last few days, I've been going into the camp every morning. It takes about an hour and a half to get there. And they sit around and watch it on a screen while we have breakfast. And it's just been too hard for me, and so I wander off. I can't sit and watch it.
He was out with us last night, so...
Is he not here? He didn't come.
So you better call the hotel ahead of time, make sure everything is tidy. Because she's coming home with a vengeance.
I wasn't expecting to come out today because I had such a good time yesterday. Ronnie Marsh is a but then I knew that. There wasn't much left for me to do apart from kill Janice Dickinson. And really, that wouldn't be a good idea on live television. Or Rodney Marsh, either of them.
Once out of the jungle, every celebrity must have a medical, where they find out how much weight they've lost.
Oh, this is Medic Hut, is it?
Yeah, well done.
Well, thank you.
I wasn't going to see you for another week.
I know. Well, you know, Janice and Rodney, what
Come
can I say?
Here,
bitch! 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 How exciting. What do I weigh now? A lot, but not what it was. It's 12
You've lost, a stone and a half.
Oh, that was my goal, a stone and a half.
Yeah.
What a fantastic way to lose weight.
Detoxing in the
gym. Oh, my God. I am so happy because that was exactly my goal. Oh, my God. The sublime to the ridiculous is incredible. Hello.
Hello, darling. Where the f*** have you been?
I absolutely stink.
You always do.
Oh.
Well, did you know I haven't been able to watch the show? It's been like, you know, it makes me feel sick watching this. I couldn't stand them bullying you and all that rubbish.
And I can't believe you're out.
Nobody can. I just talked to Josh and Monique.
Well, I know why it is, because it's because everyone that would vote for you have got better things to do on a Friday.
That's exactly what Josh said.
Next on Coming Out, there's tension between Lynn and Rodney's daughter, Joanna.
Exactly.
John is found wanting.
He hasn't shrunk, has it?
And Rodney is reunited with his good friend, Lynn.
Welcome back to I'm a Celebrity, the Coming Out Show. So far, we've seen Mark, Katie and Lynn leave camp, and the departures kept on coming.
John Burton Race was about to get his marching orders, but behind the scenes, there was tension between Lynn and Rodney's daughter, Joanna.
I can't imagine why they wouldn't get on.
It's just extremely tense. I mean, you can almost cut it, really, doing... After all the bitching and arguing that's been going on in the camp, and now that Lynn's out, Rodney's daughter's in there, she's been listening to all the things that's been said about her dad, she's getting more and more upset, and it's just getting so stressed in there at the moment.
When Lynn left, Rodney and Janice ran to the other direction instead of saying just bye. I mean, they didn't need to do anything more than just bye, good luck or something.
You both ran off to the creek! But your whole thing about honesty is kind of rude sometimes.
Why?
Extremely rude, because we all have to live in one world, so you can just have a little bit of common decency sometimes.
It's disheartening to see tension, a lot of tension in the camp, and all I can say is that Dad speaks the truth. He speaks his mind, and you know what? He's not going to be a hypocrite. He'll never be a hypocrite.
I'll tell you something. I can only talk about where I come from, OK?
You blame everything on where you came from.
Well, I do, because that's my environment. It's my environment.
But you're a grown man with a big brain. He blames it on his working-class backgrounds. Man, there's grown men out there with great working-class backgrounds that act like gentlemen.
Exactly. Janice and Ronnie are scary and they're bullies. So for them all to stand up the way they did, I am just really moved and grateful, and I just love them all so much, really. It's still very personal, you know. I haven't detached yet. It's too recent.
At the end of the day, he's not an actor. You know, he is what he is. And there's some people in the camp that obviously are used to being on stage. There's singers in there, there's actors in there. And at the end of the day, you've got to ask yourself who's really acting and who's not.
The fourth person they want to leave this year's I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here is John.
Yes.
Daddy! They'll just all starve now.
Do you mind if we run that up through your top?
I'm naked underneath, so I'll run it up for you.
Yeah, okay.
This is nasty press men. Remember to give them the happy finger, won't you, Pip? Don't speak. Hey,
Liz. I love you. I miss you.
I missed you too.
You smell nice.
Yeah.
I smell like a dog.
No, you don't. You smell quite good. Let's get out of here. Those people want to come
out of
shit,
don't they?
Oh, it's Daddy!
Thank you.
You've
been a good boy.
Yeah. Yep, have
you?
It's been shocking.
You miss Daddy? Yeah. Yeah? Do you like my hat? Look, they're like sheeted. Give me a kiss and then I'm going to go up there. Okay.
Good boy. You're going this one?
Hello.
Can you sit with
me? I'll sit with you, yeah.
Go on.
There are a couple of people that... Well, actually, there was only one that didn't do anything, so... And it just caused animosity.
Listen, just leave me alone and I'll leave you alone, okay? But I'm
just
sick and tired of your constant
about
harassment. You're a pain in the arse, now leave me alone.
See, initially I wanted to win. Then I said I thought I'd be in
the... I'm surprised you said that, because you never said that to me. You never said that.
No, it was just something clicked into my head. But then I thought...
That's
then
you're competitive, that's why.
Yeah, I know that.